Hello. In this video, I'm going to discuss the Drop-Sorb manual calculation by Excel method. But before anything else, I would like to let you know on this drawing I have here. There are three perpendiculars of the ship, namely the forward perpendicular, the midship perpendicular, and the aft perpendicular. These perpendiculars are the basis of all calculations, particularly on drop survey. In every loading of bulk cargo, a drop survey is taken to determine how many tons of cargo being loaded. We have to use the hydrostatic data to enable us to find the displacement and other relevant information. Displacement is the amount of water being displaced when the vessel is floating at summer load draft. So in other words, displacement can be obtained by the volume of displacement of under submerged in the water, the volume submerged in the water multiplied by the specific gravity that is your displacement. In the dockyard, when the vessel is newly built, the standard density being used is 1.025. So for this illustration here, on the right side of this forward perpendicular is the line of the drop marks. This is the actual drop marks. And also in the midship, there is also a drop marks. If the drop reaches 13.8 meters, then correction applies. So all drop marks on the right side of the perpendiculars, the correction is negative. While on the aft, the drop marks is on the left side of the perpendicular, therefore the correction is positive. That is if the vessel is trimmed by the stern. Otherwise, if by the head, the correction, you have to reverse the process. Forward must be positive, midship must be positive, and up is negative. So you have to reverse the process. So displacement correction due to trim, we have first and second correction. And also the density correction is applied if vessel is floating other than SG1025. The correction is negative if less than 1.025 the density, otherwise it is positive. So trim correction can be also considered as Nemoto's correction, named after the Japanese naval architect. So this is the formula of the first trim correction. The true trim or corrected trim multiplied by TPC times LCF times 100 divided by LVP. That is for the correction one. And the formula for second correction is corrected trim square multiplied by 50 times the MTC or difference of MTC and divided by LVP. Then algebraic sum. Okay. So actually this is the format wherein I have a ship here, a drawing of a ship where you can put your drop directly in here and it will automatically transfer on this side for forward. Like for example, if I will do this way, equals, then enter, then it will automatically transfer here. And then the starboard equals and click enter, then that is the drop forward starboard. So to sum up this one, this is the answer divided by 2, this is the mean of forward port and starboard. Likewise, the midship and the aft. So these are the mean drop, the mean, the average. Okay, since you have taken this forward and midship and aft, These are what we call the drop at marks or apparent drop. So if you minus 8.18 minus half drop minus forward drop, this will give you trim of 0.62 by the stern. So this is the apparent trim. Now to correct the distance, so because there the calculation should be done by drop at perpendicular, not drop at mark. So you have to correct the drop. The drop at mark should be transferred to drop at perpendiculars. So the distance forward, the stem correction is 2.38 for the forward, and at the middle is 1 meter behind the midship perpendiculars, and 10.8 is the distance of the aft correction. Is the distance 10.8 from the perpendicular where the drop marks is situated. Okay, so to get the distance between marks, so you have to subtract it from 2 to 1.5 minus 2.38 minus 10.8. So the distance between marks is 208.3, and this will be used for your trim correction or for the stem correction. Okay, so for the forward correction, point 0.62 multiplied by negative 2.38 divided by distance between marks. So this is for the forward correction, and for the stern correction, 0.62 then multiplied by 10.8. This is the up correction divided by distance between marks. So this will be the correction up. And for the mean drop, there is no correction because the drop is in light condition. So we'll just put 0. Okay. So we bring down the 18.18, the apparent drop forward, and the up drop, as well as the midship drop. So 18 plus negative 0.0070833, this will give you 8.1729. This is the drop at perpendiculars or corrected drop or real drop. Then it goes the same of the up drop plus the correction. This is the corrected drop or drop at perpendiculars, which is 8.8321. And for the midship, since there is no correction, so it will remain the same, 8.35. So we have to obtain the quarter mean, because quarter mean is being required to find your displacement. Okay, so there are two ways in getting your the quarter mean. We have the what we call the traditional method and Sorbier's formula. This is for Sorbier's formula. Quarter mean equals mean multiplied by 6 plus forward corrected and half corrected divided by 8. So for traditional forward, so this is already transferred in here, forward, perpendicular, midship, and half. So in this way, mean 1, for mean 1 you have to forward plus half divided by 2. So this is this one. Okay, equals forward plus half divided by 2. Okay, check. That is 8.5025 2976. That is what we call mean 1. So for the mean 2 equals mean 1 plus midship. Mean 1 plus midship divided by 2. So this is 8.426. for the this is the min 2, right? This is min 2. Now for the quarter main, the quarter main min 2 plus min chip. So this is your min 2 equals min 2. This y5, I think y5 plus min chip divided by 2. So this is your quarter main. Okay, this is your quarter main. And the quarter mean for Sobrevius formula, this is the formula. Okay, so they have the same answer. Derive the same answer. Okay, let us proceed for our RAP survey. So we have already the correction. And then this is the final RAP at perpendiculars. Then you have to find out the corresponding displacement of 838. So in this quarter mean we have to obtain only two digits, that means 8.38, because in the table the figure is only two digits, so 8.38. so let us find this on the hydrostatic table. So 8.38, so 8.38 is 52,179. And the LCB 645, negative 234, the LCF, and this is the MTC, and this is the TPC, tons per centimeters, 66.7. Okay. Okay, the data is already reflected in here. 66.7 LCF or LCF, center position is negative 2.32, and before we proceed, we also take note that we have to find the difference of MTC by applying 50 centimeters plus from this quarter mean and minus 50 centimeters from this quarter mean. So 8 through 8, because we eliminate 81, this 81 becomes 0.81. We will have to multiply this by the TPC in order to get the increments. Okay, 8.38, so plus 50 or 0.5 centimeters, this become 8.88. So we have the corresponding MTC is 1049.1. It can be found in this hydrostatic table. Okay. And likewise, 7.88, this is the corresponding MTC. So to get the difference of MTC, you have to subtract MTC1 minus MTC2. So the difference is 48.1. Okay, let us proceed for the trim correction. Correction 1, the formula is the apparent trim multiplied by TPC. This is true trim, I mean. It's already true trim. It's corrected trim. Okay, because if you minus this one, 8.8321 minus 8.1729, this is already corrected drop at perpendiculars. This will be your trim. This is corrected trim already, or true trim. So corrected trim multiplied by TPC, multiplied by LCA, multiplied by 100, and divided by 221.5. This is the first trim correction. Okay, negative 46.055. Okay, this is the formula here. Only simple multiplication. And this one, 50 multiplied by difference of MTC multiplied by change of the corrected trim square divided by LBP. So you have to square this one. Okay. This is the trim. So you have to raise to second power divided by 2 to 1.5. And this is the result. So algebraic sum, negative 46.055 plus 4.71857, so this is the total correction, negative 41.336. Okay. So for the density correction, since the density is 1.023 minus the standard density, that is constant 1025, divided by again salt water density 1.05 multiplied by the total displacement, the correction is negative 101.92. So you have to bring down the total displacement, then the correction is negative and positive for the second correction and the density correction. So do the algebraic sum. So the algebraic sum is 52,089.77. So since the light ship is 11,680, if you deduct from this total displacement minus light ship, this will give you cargo dead weight. This is the cargo dead weight, 40,409.77. Then minus the non-cargo weight, because you fill oil tank during the absorbe, initial the fuel is 981.68, DO is 66.05, fresh water to 60, and the ballast is 38,822. So the non-cargo weight is 40,129.73. So bring it down here. Then the cargo constant is 280. So this is the initial draft survey, 280. So let's go for the final draft survey. So upon the completion of loading, it was found out the vessel sailed out with an even keel. So this is the forward 14, 14, 14, 14, 02, 14, and 14. So this is even keel. So as the same procedure as in initial drop, this is the drop at perpendicular. This is the apparent drop. Since there is no trim, so no need to correct this one. There is no more correction because there is no apparent trim. This is even keel. So there is no more correction. No more correction. So the correction, trim correction, is only applicable if the vessel has trim. Since this is even keel, no need to have a correction. Okay. So this is the 14 meters, 14.01. Okay. Then your midship plot is 14.050 and the quarter mean is 14.0075. So you have to find the corresponding displacement for this 14.0075. Likewise, you have to get the two digits 14.00 plus 0.5. Then the result is the MTC1 is 14.5. The corresponding value is 1176.1. And 14 minus 50 or 0.5 meters, this is 13.5, and this is the corresponding value MTC. So get the difference of the two, then this is 8.9. So since this is the quarter mean displacement, so you have to add the last two digit because there is two digits here, 0.75. So this 0.75, this is the increment of the displacement. So what you have to do is equals get 0.75. So you have to drop down the 75, so make it 0.75 multiplied by the TPC. So your TPC is 69.8, and then enter. So this is your increment. So algebraic sum, this is your true displacement, this is your displacement, 90884.35. Okay, so since there is a density correction, 1023 minus 1025, so this is 105 multiplied by 90,884.35. So this is the density correction. So we have to put it here down. So algebraic sum, this is the total displacement, 90,707. Then the light ship is 11,680. Then the cargo dead weight is 79,027.01. Then your cargo weight is 1,220. So deduct this from the cargo dead weight, then this will give you the cargo constant 77,807.01. So therefore, since this is cargo and constant, you have to subtract the constant because you already know the constant, which is 280. So you have to subtract this one, then this will be your total cargo. The total cargo is 77,527 round off. So you have already the cargo, the initial and the final survey. So at the final survey, you are able to get the total cargo loaded of your vessel. Okay, so I think that is all for now, and I hope you enjoy watching my presentation. Thank you and have a nice day.